We often see life as a journey up the hill, where on top of this hill is the universe knowledge, how everything works, how things happen, the understanding of unity, oneness, acceptance, unconditional love, it's all on top. Sad part is we often are too old by the moment when we finally reach the top of comprehension. This subjective approach is kind of like taking yourself and putting at the very top of this mountain. And at first you don't even see, because we think dually, right? We being on the very top, we have too much happening around. It's a lot of information and a lot of filters. We don't see everything. Then we begin to clear it a bit. We start seeing a bit more, a bit further, a bit deeper. And eventually it comes to us, this very understanding. We are placed at the very center of this unconditional love, and soon we see it. I'm gonna talk about it. Hello, I'm Svetlana. Introducing myself from now on. This is the, I call it, fastest way to change everything in yourself. Let's talk about love as part of it. As I said, you accept from the beginning the idea that you are the center of your universe. You are on top of this mountain. And by default, you don't wait the moment when after years you figure out that you are one by going through certain experiences, transformations. Right away, you take it as the truth that everyone and everything is part of the same big system, which functions perfectly. Anything bad, we think it is bad. In fact, it's the system for some reason needs it. System, universe, world, whichever you call. If you are from spiritual community, you know what I'm talking about. I mean, the oneness. If it sounds foreign to you, that's fine. That means that just as with everyone, me included, when I first was introduced to this idea, it's just filters. Filter of separation from others, filters that me. Got to protect, got to survive, got to feed yourself and those who are family, which means separating them from the rest of humans, when in fact all of this is just one universe. And that's where you begin. I am the reason of everything happening in my world, and everything around is my reflection, because the unity, the oneness. You see where it's coming from. Another little piece is that love is a default. Anything that doesn't match it, I call it a bug in consciousness. Consciousness is a software. It's designed to be unconditionally loving and accepting of everything. So anything that doesn't match is a bug. So you place yourself at this top of the mountains that everything is your reflection, is you, your continuity. And from there, you begin to wash your glasses, your eyes, wherever you see that doesn't match inner peace equals living happily equals loving equals great, and it's all about the same, you see? You clear it. And I talked about filters and desires. I'll link the video. When you see something that doesn't make you happy, you begin disentangling. Why do I want to not be happy? And if I have any kind of information, guilt, shame, got to earn happiness, can't be happy without pain because pain is a beautiful instrument for feeling. It's all filters. So removing these filters, patching them, and at the same time working with your desires as the root system of reality happening around you, your universe. I call it your universe because it's perception. You perceive world from your point, your data in your mind. You have collected specific information through which you see, perceive the world. Specific details are filters. See, you can accept this as a placeholder truth for now until you find the insight in you when it says, aha, I know now what all of this 100-year-old. Until you reach that moment, take it as the placeholder truth if it doesn't match right now your belief system. And that becomes the point of your journey. You take it as a starting point and then you expand the pretty much in every direction, rewiring, changing every thing that comes to you that contradicts. Unless you're dealing with a specific kind of situation when you have a disease, for example. So it's like being on timer. If you don't find all the reasons, you die, right? Not pleasant situations. If you have something like this, then you concentrate your attention most likely on one thing. Why do I want to have cancer? Why do I want to die? Why do I want to have cancer and not some other? Why didn't I die right away? Why do I have to do it? And as I said, on top of the mountain, when you can't see yet, you bump into things a bit here and there, probably hurting sometimes. This is what I call messy cleanups. But you stay on top. You are already placed there and you're rooted with this thing that I am the only reason of this world existing, because you cut your mind off and your world will stop, it will stop existing. Think about it. Comprehend it if it didn't hit you yet. And it doesn't mean, see, that others are not as unique or as important. It's not about importance because it's still the same. It's all you, your reflection. Other people's happiness is exact information for you to see that you are also happy. When you see someone starving, where do you cut yourself? Or why do you want that person to be hungry while you are thriving? Greediness, having stocking food for something, for better times, expectations, fear of not being in abundance at every moment or any moment in the future. All of these are filters, see? Cut, 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 patch, patch, patch. While disentangling desires, which appear as soon as you found enough desires, it's like this, changing. And after these cleanups are a bit off, you stopped bumping into things, you begin to check, look specifically at some things and tweak their relationship, tick, 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 poke, see how it reacts, or some interesting new game, play something you haven't tried before. Then look at others, see a neighbor is struggling. Oh, interesting. I want to see how it happens. And then you sit and watch how the person transforms. You don't even have to do anything. You just change it in your mind. It's an interesting game. One by one, you rewire everything. You transform every single thing that comes to you. Change it with the single question, why do I want this? And another question. Am I happy? Am I loving? Am I inspired? If not, back to the first question, why not? Why do I want not to be inspired? Because I'm worried that if I create something, I will be judged or it won't be needed. One by one, pull out all of these reasons, change them, transform them, and watch how you are changing everything in you, with the only thing that never changes is love. What changes about it is that it grows, it becomes bigger and bigger and bigger in you when you are not scared to look in yourself anymore. I'm talking about myself, it's easy to love everyone. Yeah, the dogs. It's easy to like the barking dogs. But at the moments of the very depth, I look inside and I see to the point of pain, I am still having those roots of not having full love for myself, which is the core of the universe. See, you got to love yourself fully. While you see anything that is not love around you, that means one thing: you need to continue rewiring yourself, transforming everything in you that is left. It's also a journey, but it's already not the journey to straight the line, changing zigzags. It's not. You basically are in one point, your center, and the mountain just goes below you into different directions. You kind of watch how it all becomes more, and every time you turn your head, your attention, you see how it runs further and how beautiful it is. That's an interesting journey. That's the journey when you begin from the very top of the mountain without being scared that you don't see anything. All you need to do is want to feel that, because majority people like walking up the hill, because we kind of have an idea how to do that. Do we want to be innovator and then invent something new? Adios.
It's so nice to have the family together for dinner.
Harold!
Shrek!
Fiona!
Fiona!
Mom!
Harold!
Donkey!